Hi there, my name is Daniel Scott, and this is our Microsoft Excel 2016 cheat sheet. Check out my full Excel course on bringyourownlaptop.com. All right, before I forget, there's also a printable PDF version that you can print off and stick next to your desk and look all awesome. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com/resources. Okay, so the first tip from our cheat sheet is to insert a column. So I need to add my headers, so I'm going to click in this top row here and go Control, Shift, and hit Plus. Okay, it allows me to put in either the rows or the columns. Great. Next tip, I'm going to type in January, okay, or just Jan. And if I grab the bottom right square and drag it across, Excel's pretty clever and knows that I mean this string of dates. Okay, works the same for days of the week. If I type in Monday or Mon, okay, and I drag it out, okay, it puts in the days of the week as well. Thank you, Excel. Next cheat is selecting all of these, and I want them to be currency because pretty much they're always a currency in Excel. So Control Shift and hit 4 on your keyboard, and that'll put it to your default currency. Mine's set to pounds at the moment, yours might be dollars. Next tip is, say you want to select the whole bit of data that you've got. Mine's pretty small. Yours might be huge, lots and lots of rows and columns. Just hit Control A and it selects the whole thing. This is going to segue into a cool little under home along here where it says format as table. I'm going to pick one of the predefined ones, click OK, and it's going to make it a pretty little table for me. Next shortcut is Control and then Tab on your keyboard, normally just above caps lock on the left. Okay, and I'm gonna click that and it toggles between any open Excel files. So if you've got a couple that you're copying and pasting from, Control Tab between the two. Next shortcut is, say, the date. You wanna enter today's date, just hit Control colon. Okay, and it's put in my exact today's date. Okay, so using my Control Tab again to jump to my next open Excel document, I want to do a couple of things. One is, I'm working on this long document, it's really long. Okay, I can double click the bottom of any cell and it jumps me all the way to the end of that column. Cool, huh? But wouldn't it be handy if I had my header rows along the top here, okay? Because I have no idea what maybe this number is, okay, while I'm all the way down there. So what we can do is go to View, go to Freeze Planes, and here I'm going to freeze the top row. You could do the first column, okay, but I'm going to do the row. It just means when I scroll down, hey, look at that, stuck to the top. You can unfreeze it by going to Unfreeze Panes. Another handy cheat sheet for working with this type of data, okay, is I'm going to select all, member, Control A grabs my whole bit of data, and I'm going to go along Home, and I'm going to go to this one that says Sort and Filter, and I'm going to hit Filter. And that's all I need to do to turn on these cool little drop-down menus. It just means that I need to hunt out the people who haven't paid. So I'm going to drop down this menu and I'm going to unselect all and click unpaid. Then I'm going to find these people, okay, and try and wrestle money from them. That is the sorting and filtering. So I'm going to undo that to turn my sorting off, okay. And last thing I want to do is something called flash fill, okay. It's going to be our last of our shortcuts. And remember, in this column here, I'm going to hit Control Shift Plus to insert a column for me. Thank you very much. And flash fill does some cool stuff where I want to join these two names, okay, because at the moment they're separated. And what I can do is if I type in Gwendo, man, I picked the toughest name of them all, okay, and I put it how I want it, okay, that's how I want it, please. And what we can do is just underneath here we can hit under data, okay, there's one called flash fill, and you see it goes through and it knows what I mean now and starts joining them all up. Flash fill can be used for all sorts of things. It can be used to pull these names apart as well as putting them together. And I said that was the last of the cheat sheets, but it's not. Go to File, go to New. Don't be afraid to use the templates, okay? There's so much in here. If you need an invoice, okay, you can follow my course and do it, or you can cheat. And just go find an invoice that looks kind of close to what you want, switch out the logos, and you're away. Now remember, this cheat sheet's just a little bit from my longer course on learning Excel. Check it out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also remember, on that same website, there is a resources tab along the top and you can download a PDF with all of these tips we just went through in a nice printable format where you can stick it up next to your desk. My name is Dan Scott and I will see you later. Hey, did you enjoy it? If you did, please click subscribe or like, click the little alert bell as well. All of these things really help me as a business. Also, if you want the full course, check out the Excel Bootcamp on bringyourownlaptop.com. There's that course plus many others. All right, bye now.